Presently, a substantial amount of information is emerging from Avdiivka. Avdiivka persists as the primary focal direction for Russian forces and the locus of the highest frequency of daily combat engagements. Regardless of the impeded advances, from the perspective of Russian leadership, the northern sector continues to be deemed as holding the greatest potential for progress, despite the area around the infamous chemical factory has indeed manifested as a profound source of distress for the Russian military. In recent times, the cohesive nature of Russian onslaughts in the vicinity has seen a decline. Reports from the 47th Mechanized Brigade of Ukrainian forces suggest that recent offensives lacked the support of tanks or armored machinery, with sizes of assault groups diminishing and a notable drop in the coordination of these assaults. It appears every group operates with a divergent objective in mind. Freshly disclosed combat visuals capture one such improvised assault. The Russians are dispatching compact contingents of foot soldiers to stealthily encroach on vacant ditches, trenches, or buildings to secure a position within Stepov. It was unveiled by members of the Korn Group of Ukrainian forces that these movements were actually meant to bolster a pair of soldiers who had previously infiltrated a trench. Regrettably for the Russians, the Korn Group made use of the so-named Baba Yaga octocopters to eliminate the hideout with a substantial explosive, resulting in the loss of 6 troops. Advancing towards the Russian-held tree-line fronting Stepov, thermal imaging exposed 2 additional trenches occupied by Russian forces. The initial trench contained 5 soldiers, all eliminated, and the adjacent trench housed 6 soldiers, of which 3 were neutralized and 3 sustained injuries. The 47th Mechanized Brigade of Ukraine kept up their offensive throughout the day, employing routine kamikaze drones, leading to the discovery and subsequent targeting of 2 Russian soldiers taking a smoke break in a trench, who unsuccessfully attempted to intercept the drone. As a whole, conditions in the Stepov region have attained greater consistency. Certain analysts ascribe this downturn in conflict intensity to a momentary depletion of forces, while others contend it results from a recent spate of strikes on Donetsk and logistical hubs in the area. Considering the observed mobilization of Russian troops, ranging from 150 to 300, to Krasnohorivka 2 days prior, deficiencies in manpower are likely not the sole explanation, and the impact of HIMARS and Storm Shadow operations seems to have substantially weakened Russian offensives, albeit temporarily. Another lethal avenue of attack in this sector has emerged as the staunch stronghold situated between Stepov and the chemical plant, encircled by concrete barricades as previously discussed. In a similar pattern to Stepov, the Russian military is constantly commissioning fresh units to gain dominion over this ambiguous zone. There is an impression that Ukrainian defenders from the 110th Brigade, charged with this sector, are deliberately maintaining it as a contested gray zone to lure more Russian forces into the fray. Combat videos indicate a new squad dispatched bidaily by the Russians to seize the space within these barriers. Several Russians meet their demise via mortar fire whilst en route, and the survivors are systematically pursued by drones over a span of 2 days. Should the incoming assault team be larger than the norm, Ukrainian forces have been known to deploy a Bradley for firepower suppression via machine gun. The 110th Mechanized Brigade of Ukraine recently directed a drone flyover above this 100-meter expanse to display the extent of Russian casualties. Visual evidence reveals a considerable tally of Russian soldiers fallen whilst attempting to secure and hope for additional forces to bolster their position. The drone footage showed the remains of 33 troops, the count of those retrieved after Russian units managed a brief advancement through the tree-line, potentially clearing their dead, remains undisclosed. In summary, Ukrainian defense forces have achieved stabilization of the front line, with each division devising specific, effective strategies for sustainable defense. For instance, the 110th Mechanized Brigade has identified and transformed a critical passage point for the Russian offense into a lethal trap. Moreover, the 47th Mechanized Brigade is exploiting regions abundant in defensive formations to wear down the opposition before initiating counterstrikes. In parallel, those guarding the chemical facility have established numerous machine gun posts within the expansive structures to oversee and dominate every segment of the adversary's positions amidst the trees fronting the factory.